And we are live. Hello, everyone, and welcome to another Anthem live stream. My name is Ben Irving. I'm one of the lead producers for Anthem. And joining me today, we have a very special guest, Darren McPherson. Darren, would you like to introduce yourself to our amazing fans?
Yeah. Hi, fans. I'm the producer for gameplay, here to talk about some really cool things.
That's right. So, to that point, today's stream topic is all about loot, gear, and progression. It's been a really exciting journey, I think, going through all of these streams. We've talked about Our World, My Story. We've talked about javelins. We've talked about gear, weapons, and abilities outside of the streams. We talked about personalization two streams ago. But the one thing we really haven't got into is, how does progression work? How does loot work? What are rarities? How do the stats work? Can I make builds and loadouts?
Yep.
And our goal today is to talk everyone through all of that stuff, which is exciting.
Let's do it.
So, we're going to flip over to the game now and look at the Forge. So, we've talked about this before. The Forge is split into two core sections. We have loadouts and appearances. We often call that customization and personalization. So personalization is about how you look, your appearance, and customization, or the loadouts, as you see in the UI here, is about your power. So as we dive into this, Darren, can you just talk a little bit about what are the kind of UI elements we see here? And then after that, just the summary of
So each javelin has five hard points or equipable slots that you're going to have. Those are broken up into different types. So you've got here, so you see weapons, the Colossus specific heavy assault launcher. The Ranger has a different one. The Storm has a different one. So they have different names. Ordnance launcher is his rear mounted artillery, components, and support gear.
Right. And so in the past, we've talked about, you know, there are three gear pieces. So here it's kind of heavy assault launcher, ordnance launcher, support gear. That would be the three for the Colossus.
Right.
You have two weapons. If you, when we drill into the weapons, you'll see. And then components, which we haven't talked about yet. And we'll save that for a moment. We'll get there in a second. So that's the construct for how you can equip things and do things with your character. But before we dive in, what's the, like, overall system? Like, you have a pilot, the pilot has levels, like, how do, what other parts are there to progressing your character as you play the game?
Okay, so you just like a normal RPG, you have levels. Your pilot, in this case, it's not an exo level, it's a pilot level.
Right.
So as you progress in your pilot, you unlock certain things, like, for instance, if I want a second weapon, I get that at four. So I start with a single one, etc. These slots are unlocked, some of them relatively early in the game. And then as you play the game, you'll loot items.
Yep.
Those items have levels on them.
Okay.
Those items also have rarities. So if you're familiar with other RPGs, there are there's generally common, and so we have common, we have uncommon, we have rare, and then we have epic, and then we have a couple that we'll talk about later. That make up basically our six rarity types.
Awesome. So you have a pilot level, and as you increase that, you get more powerful loot, and then rarity scales amongst those levels as well. Okay, cool. So that's the overview. Now we need to describe, well, how does this look like? So we'll start pretty simply with an uncommon item. So here we have the Firewall Mortar. Do you want to just explain what are we seeing here and what all these stats mean?
So we have our stat block. This, as it says, is a Firewall Mortar. So it does fire damage. You can see here
in
the
wall,
damage is fire. Okay. Yeah, it lays a wall down.
Okay.
It had. You can see that it's recharge time. And fire status. So fire status is sort of a new stat for games like this, which is how quickly do you light someone on fire in this case, or if it were ice status, how quickly do you freeze them, etc.
Okay. So this is a good little segue. So that's important to our combo system.
Yes.
So the idea here is that you would apply a status effect. Once you apply enough of it on a certain creature, it's now primed,
right?
And then you could get a gear piece that's a detonator and use that to do a combo.
Yep.
Is that right?
So we have things that, that apply an effect, and then things that will then create combos when that effect is there.
So this one puts effects on. How do, is there a way to tell that here?
Yeah, so if you look to the left of Firewall Mortar, the name, there's a little symbol there that happens to look like a flame, but that is our universal icon for this thing will add a
build
status.
Status effects. Right. Okay, cool.
And you know, some things will build a lot slower than others. So while most of the things that apply an element of ice or whatever will build up, some of them are, so would take a long time to build up.
Okay, gotcha. Okay,
but this one's really good at it.
And then, so that's most of it. There's one little part here. Oh, every stream, Ben forgets the caveats. So, a couple of caveats.
Why are there zeros in there, Ben?
Awkward. So, this is still a game we're working on. It's not finished. And in this build, we have a bunch of bugs. And so, one of the bugs we have here is all of the numbers for this next part are all zeros. Obviously, in the real game, they won't be zeros. In fact, most of the numbers here are a work in progress or have bugs to them. So please don't read into any of the numbers here, the damage numbers, the fire
balance
status
still
numbers,
continues,
the percentages. That's all work in progress. Right. So with that being said, when you see 0% pickup radius, that's obviously not the actual
Not
number.
As good as you would want.
Not as good as you would want. Okay, so now that I remembered to do that thing I was meant to do at the very start, can you explain, there is a thing here that says 0% pickup radius.
Right.
What is that?
So that's an inscription. Okay. So each item that you get above common rarity, so uncommon and above, will have a number of inscriptions on them. These are stats that will have a random range of value. So this could hypothetically be 5 to 10%.
Right.
You get this item and you get a 7% bonus. Okay, cool. That's good. There's over 100 actual different inscriptions you can get on an item, broken up into a few pools for us to organize and balance. So on some of them, you're going to get extra damage stats. On some of them, you're going to get secondary utility, things like that.
Yeah. So just to clarify for everyone watching, that would mean every time you get a firewall mortar, it does the firewall.
Yep.
That's the thing. It does damage. It applies status effects. But if you get uncommon or higher, you get a random roll. And those things would be different every time. So the core functionality is the same, but all the bonuses are different.
Yep.
Is that right?
Yep.
Okay. So we just covered a lot of stuff.
Okay.
Let's wait for a second. Do we have any questions that have come in that are related to that? Okay. So first question, will we be able to craft legendary weapons and gear, or are those specifically only available as loot drops in the world? Okay, so we're going to touch on legendary weapons and gear a bit later. I think we can still answer the question, though. Because replace that with epic. Can we get purple legendary weapons and gear?
The primary means of gaining gear, weapons, components, is randomly through killing creatures or defeating objectives, et cetera.
Yep.
So you can eventually get some of the ability to get some recipes to craft some of these things. Crafting is a good supplement to not, I didn't get the assault rifle I wanted, but maybe I got the recipe, then I can then craft that.
Yep, cool. I think you just kind of answered that question. The other question we just got here was, will loot be RNG-based, or will we have specific mission strongholds that, so the answer to that question is just what you said, right? Like, for the most part, you go out into the world and you get random loot.
But, let me clarify one thing, though. The based on your level, you will get more high chance for you to get a better rarity.
Right.
So if I'm level 5, it's really hard for me to get an epic piece. It feasibly could happen, but but as I get closer to 20, that will start happening more frequently.
Yeah. And then if you play harder difficulties, harder content, your chance of getting higher rarities will increase.
Right. So if I'm level 30, I'm in a dungeon, that's a really good chance for me to get epic drops, bigger, better loot.
Okay. So I just saw a question in chat come through that was, can we trade with other players? So our answer to that is no. Like, we want this to be about the loot you go out and get yourself.
Right.
And again, if you end up in a situation where you don't get the things, you're like, oh, I really want an assault rifle, and an assault rifle never drops, then the thing you could do is, to your point, supplement with crafting.
Mm-hmm.
So you could find a challenge that rewards an assault rifle blueprint, which is our recipes. And then get the materials and craft that if you really just wanted to have an assault rifle and you were getting unlucky for some reason and not getting your hands on one. Okay, so that's a couple of questions. We might get back into the explanation. So we covered the ordnance launcher, which was a green uncommon piece. Yep. We're going to look at the heavy assault launcher now.
Yep. So we have our flamethrower. So again, fire damage. This builds up fire status. And you see our inscriptions here. I have javelin heat damage, which affects all the heat or fire damage that I would do as a player. So that's a really good roll to have on this item. And then I get extra shotgun ammo.
Right. So here, I think you might have mentioned it, but here we have two inscriptions, and before we had one.
Right.
How does that work?
Yeah, so from common to uncommon, sorry, from uncommon to rare, you get an additional inscription. And that number grows up to four. Well, up to four,
we'll get
caveating
there.
Later,
we'll get there. Yeah.
Rarities.
And all four would be random rolls from
random
this
rolls
giant
from,
list
well,
that are available.
From different pools. So we, yeah. you know, as you get an item, you get a weapon at level 20, it'll roll from a primary damage pool. So that primary damage pool is what you is going to increase your damage of some kind.
Yep.
As opposed to sometimes I get something that isn't maybe as exciting like pickup radius, but it's still helpful. As opposed to I
More
got
like
a really good one and I
stuff.
Got yeah.
So like flight time extensions would
right.
that
well,
be in that
yeah.
pool?
Yeah. And you know depending on your build, that's really flight time extension. We'll see a little later. Yeah. Is super valuable.
Or you might decide you want to do speed runs, so having a huge pickup radius is great because you can go through and pick things
Let
up.
Let me tell you, playing as a storm with big pickup radius is huge.
Oh, good point. Good point. Okay, so that covers off the assault launcher and kind of the rare items. I think we're going to look at a epic one, a purple one.
So I wanted to talk about this one. So this is common. This is the lowest rarity. And here on the side of the railgun on the left side, you see the combo icon. So
the
each one
primer,
of these.
Right.
Right.
Oh, the detonator, sorry.
It's a detonator. Yeah. So each one of the things that does that, that says this detonates explosive combo.
So if we had used our other piece to put a creature in fire status.
And then I use
you
this.
You could use this for a combo effect.
Right.
And then I don't think we should digress here, but then each of the suits have a different effect when they combo.
Yep.
We could cover it real quick, I guess.
Yeah. So the Colossus here has explosive combo, so he does damage to the primary target that has been primed, and then an AoE around it.
Yep.
Right. The Ranger does a high impact single target damage, enormous amounts of damage. The Storm. So the guy's frozen, and he hits him. He does not only does damage to that guy, but he chains
Spreads
the ice
the frozen
to other
effect.
People.
Yep.
And the Interceptor is my favorite. You go in.
You kind of have a favorite child, but continue.
I can. I'm allowed to. They don't talk back to me. They don't get jealous. Well, they might. I don't know. You hit the prime target with one of your combos, and now you are surrounded by an aura of that element. So then I drag that around and freeze or apply acid.
Right, you can
to
apply that
else.
Aura where you move. Right. Yeah. So there's a lot of depth there to the combo system, which maybe should be its own tune of itself, but we covered a lot of the basics anyway. Okay, so we've gone through that. Next, let's take a look at some epic stuff.
So we'll dive into the weapons really quick, which have a few different effects. So here's our grenade launcher. Again, heavy weapon. Have we ever covered heavy weapons on these streams?
No.
Okay. So we're doing it now.
Okay, let's
So this is a heavy weapon. Heavy weapons can only be used by the Colossus.
Right.
Which is cool. So there's the grenade launcher and the autocannon, big, massive.
Yep, only for the Colossus.
Only for the Colossus. Here's a marksman. Again, you can be used by anybody. So you can see its damage, its optimal range. That's where you're going to do the most damage. If it's farther than that, the damage will be lower. And then, of course, it's got inscriptions.
You now have the three inscriptions.
Right.
Yep. Okay. So and then, the rest kind of is similar enough to that. The one thing, support gear is we don't need to probably go into, but the one thing we didn't really cover in the general of Anthem communication was components.
Which is new. Right.
Which is kind of new to explain. So, again, this comes back to that notion that we've separated vanity and power, what we're calling personalization and customization.
Mm-hmm.
And so in personalization, you pick the helmet you want to wear and the chest and the legs and the arms, for example. But there are no stats associated to it. And so players have been asking, well, but isn't that kind of annoying because I like that I have stats there. And so what we've done instead is have a series of components that bring that back. So not only do they add stats to your suits, but they add other abilities. But why don't I hand over to you and you explain components and some of the things that they do.
I agree with everyone saying those same things.
Yeah.
How do I customize my playstyle? How do I customize how I what I do, how am I incentivized to go down a specific path and pursue a specific item, mm-hmm. for instance. So components are the answer to that. So let me dive into these two on this one. There's many, many more that you can get. Component's primary purpose is to allow you to tailor and customize the playstyle that you want. So
what's an example?
So an example of this is right here.
Perfect.
All blast damage, which means explosions. There are things that aren't explosive that do blast damage.
Yeah.
So we're very specific here. Is increased. Now, obviously, percentage, no, 0% isn't good. We have right. a bug in there.
Right.
But if I wanted to focus on doing explosives, I would maybe this is an item I would choose. These also have up to two inscriptions on them.
Okay.
So the difference between this explosives expert and another one would be the inscriptions could be the rarity. The power level of it.
I think explosions is a good one. It's like more damage. What are other ones? Are there utility things to focus on?
So there are some utility things. I need more ammo in my. I've got an autocannon. I want more ammo.
Right.
You take the thing that gives you either more ammo for all your weapons, or there's a specific Colossus one that gives you more autocannon ammo, or more ammo for all of your weapons.
One question we get asked a lot is, hey, can, you know, flight's cool, I love flying, will I be able to extend my flight time?
Oh, yeah.
Is this where you do that?
So you can do this in a couple ways. You can do it here. So you get an inscription that gives you more thruster lifetime.
Right.
Or you get that, and if you roll really well, you get it also as your inscriptions. So your inscriptions give you more thruster. So I can fly for a much longer time or hover for a much longer time if I choose to specialize in that.
Yeah. And one little point, and then we're going to move on here. So this is pretty complicated. And so sometimes in talking through it, it's like, hey, well, what if I just like want to enjoy playing the game and equip stuff versus being a min-maxer? Like is there, does this cater to both groups?
Yeah. So it's, again, components are meant to allow you to very easily customize your play, and it is not very complicated. It can get complicated, but it's to what degree you want to participate in
right.
that. If I feel like I want more ammo, I'm going to equip the
just
one that gives me
more
ammo.
Stuff on. Yeah.
If I happen to be using an assault rifle because that was the latest drop that I got, and you have the component for assault rifle damage or assault rifle ammo, equip it.
Yeah.
So they're
and
pretty self-explanatory.
On the
easy.
End, it's like, okay, if I have a specific group I want to play with, a specific comp, and I need to do things, I could get really deep in min-max.
The second one, the overclock regulator, the second one you see here, and that has some obvious benefits to the. I both have my firewall mortar. I have electricity gear pieces that I can do as a Colossus. So that's a pretty good item.
Right.
But when I combine that with other things that boost elemental damage or that do elemental damage, then I begin to have some synergy with additional items.
Got it.
So,
all right. So I think we've covered this build a little bit.
Okay.
So what we want to do next, so first of all, let's see if we can get a couple questions as we're rolling into the next topic. But Darren very kindly set up this Colossus loadout, and we were looking at it, it was like, man, it would be cool to show like a high-end, like a really high-end loadout, and so you made an extra loadout that is a masterwork
loadout. Yeah.
So first, let's talk about, we talked rarities up to epic. There are two more. Do you want to explain what comes next, and at the same time, let's swap to the ranger and see what you've put together for us.
So rarities beyond epic are masterwork and legendary.
Yep.
So a masterwork. Let me go to here. I can't speak and
you got to do two things at once.
So a masterwork item is a higher rarity, higher power level
mm-hmm.
Than an epic, and also each one comes with a masterwork property.
Okay.
Some special thing that it does over and beyond what its normal things are. So we can look at the assault, like we look at our assault launcher. You can get a high explosive missile, I think it's called a blast missile in the game, mm-hmm. at any rarity. But when you get the masterwork version, it comes with a new orange text.
Right.
So this is an upgraded version of that when you defeat an enemy, an explosion happens, that an electric explosion happens.
Okay. So you've got this special property. I then see you've got the four inscriptions.
You've got four inscriptions.
So if I was to get another Argos mace, the special property would be the same.
Right.
And then the four inscriptions would be different.
Yeah.
So
right.
you might want to get multiple Argos maces to get the perfect combination of inscriptions.
Depending on how chasing that. Deep you want to go, you'll make or collect as many as you can until you get like javelin blast damage. That's good for me.
Yeah, this is blast damage. You want to make it blast damage.
I want thruster life, so you'll see. All of this leads to me getting a full build together.
And then above Masterworks is Legendaries, which we don't have examples here today, but do you want to explain?
Yeah, so take a Masterwork item and give it a level upgrade. Same properties, but probably a deeper inscription pool, different inscriptions that it can pull from, and more power.
And more
power. The same property.
It's like kind of the same but more powerful version. It's like the ultimate chase for the people who will play
very
the game
hard
the most
to get.
And do the hardest content and are the most dedicated. Okay.
It's the big chase item in there.
All right. Little breath here. We have got some questions that have banked
up.
Can you explain the gear score more?
So each item that you have has a power. You see the power level. Mm-hmm. Those values added together form your gear score. We use that to say this content is appropriate for someone of your level.
Right. And so you can see in the top right, Al says legendary range. I think that's a bug.
It's
probably
a bug.
Should say masterwork range because
correct.
We're in masterworks. But then, the sum of that
all of my
gear
parts
is 433.
Is 433. So if I were to take some of these items off, you'd see that bar go down, and then suddenly I'm now an epic ranger.
Yeah, and as you cross thresholds, you'll go through the rarities. Awesome. This is another question. I'll answer it. Is inventory space limited? So yes, there is a limit because there has to be because that's how servers work. It's pretty large though, and so the idea is that you have plenty of space to keep enough of these things that you need for your different loadouts, but you will have to maintain it a little bit. Like in most games, you fill up and you realize half of it is junk, and
you keep it for a rainy day
and salvage it. Which salvaging in our game is really important because it gives you crafting materials.
Right.
So you'll want to break down the things you're not using or you don't need anymore, and use them to craft stuff. So yes, there is a cap. It's meant to be big enough that you can freely do all this stuff, but there's a limit at some point.
Like our engineers start complaining when it gets too much.
Yeah. Will blueprints scale with you when
it's a good
you
question.
Unlock them?
So basically, I think the question is, if I get a blueprint at level 5, let's say it. Let's say something crazy happened and I'm level 20 and I get a masterwork blueprint and I create that. You would then create a level 20 version of that.
Right.
And then if you were level 30. So it's basically whatever level you are,
you'll
craft it at that.
So you create the same one.
You don't need a new recipe.
Level 31.
Yeah, you don't need a new recipe.
Okay.
It's not level
30. So the recipe, it gets created for the current level when you craft
it. Yes,
right. I didn't know that. That's good. Is there a way to re-roll inscriptions?
The method for re-rolling inscriptions to recraft the item.
Okay, so if you're crafting an item, you craft lots of it into the inscriptions you want. If you just got an item, the answer is to go out and get the item again.
Right.
So you can't re-roll except for crafting.
Okay. Right.
Perfect. All right. So let's get back to our build. So we're gonna get deep here. I think it's about to get complicated.
Take a seat. Buckle your seatbelt.
Get a spreadsheet out.
Yeah.
Get a pencil and a calculator. We're going to just talk through Darren's build, the different pieces of it, and then at the end we'll talk about the synergies. I think if we gave the high level thing. You've created a build that excels at being a ranger who hovers.
Right.
And by using gear, you can do lots of bonus damage and hover longer and reduce cooldowns and keep doing lots of gear.
Right. So I hover, I do explosive damage.
Yep.
I do ultimates as much as possible. That's the three key pieces.
Right. So let's explain how that works.
Okay. So we'll start with the components, which are... For this build, the most important thing. Now, I want to be super clear here. I'm focused on explosions, which are coming from gear.
Right.
But the other build that I was
playing with
was an impact build, which would have been focused on weapons.
Your weapons. Yeah.
And then I have gear that actually does impact damage as well. So it's the opposite.
So I guess the point there is there are lots of different builds you can make. And I think the players will come up with many that we never even thought of.
I hope so.
This is just one example to show kind of the depth. And the kind of choices you'll have as you're doing this yourselves.
Okay, so airborne advantage is a ranger-only component. While I'm hovering, my gear recharge rate is increased by half. Huge.
So like a 10-second thing
becomes 5 seconds.
5 seconds.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I can do my gear more often. Okay. It's ridiculous.
It's ridiculous. Okay.
So on this one, it's a little confusing. When I defeat an enemy with the left bumper.
Right bumper.
Well, with my right bumper, my left bumper gets more damage.
Okay, so
in my case, it happens to be a high explosive blast missile and a grenade, both of which do explosive damage.
Right. So you defeat an enemy with the missile, then when you throw your grenades, you're doing 50% extra damage.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. That's if amazing. I time it, requires some timing. So there's some skill involved here.
Right. Absolutely.
Which is good. While not integral to my build. Mm-hmm. If I get multi-kills, which happens a lot with a grenade that does a lot of damage, my shields are restored.
Right. So if you defeat an enemy with your missile, then you throw your grenade at three people, it's doing double damage. If it kills them, recharge shields.
Right.
So if I'm in the thick of things, I could stay in longer if I'm executing my rotation properly. Okay.
So tip of the spear. I want to use my ultimate a lot. Mm-hmm. Because and I'll show you why, and I'll show you how I'm doing that later. But when I use my ultimate, it increases my gear damage by 50%. So that stacks with the other one.
Okay.
So I will more likely be able to trigger them.
Yep.
For 5 seconds. Also very integral to my thing. And then I pulled in a couple things that were really good epic versions of my standard pieces because I want my assault launcher to do more damage. And that 5% is actually higher than that. It's a bug with the value. And I want to throw out as many grenades as I can.
Clearly, that we're trending.
Yes,
that way.
I got to trend. Yeah. So I want the recharge rate as low as possible.
And so I think you can really see the difference between the masterwork items are really interesting.
Yes.
And then the lower rarities are impactful to your playstyle, but it requires less thought into how you'd piece them together.
Right. So this Grenadier inscription. I could get that level 5, 6.
Right.
It will obviously not be an epic version of it,
and it wouldn't have the inscriptions.
Right. Yet.
Okay.
So it builds up in layers. The players don't have to gulp it all down at the same time.
So that's components, but that's not the end of the build, right? There are a few extra pieces that are
important. So let's look at this guy. So this is my my blast missile. Electric explosion when I defeat an enemy. So I want to do more explosive damage as much as I can. This allows me to do that.
You also had, when you defeat an enemy, your grenades get more damage, but also when you defeat an enemy, it does bonus damage as well.
Yeah.
So you're like defeating an enemy, explosion damage, and bonus grenade damage.
Yeah, so I want to do as much damage as possible.
So it starts all stacking up into, exactly.
Okay. Now, I've also got thruster life here, because I want to hover as much as I can.
Mm-hmm.
And
which
I've
we'll
got javelin blast damage.
When we get to the weapon, especially. Yeah.
Okay, so, let's look at the grenade.
Grenade first, okay.
So this is on a small multi-kill, I add that number is bugged. Don't worry, it's not 1,000.
But
10%.
It could be 1,000.
I mean, it could be if we were 1,000. Crazy, but yes.
Okay, that's fine.
So that's 10%, but you're gonna get this a lot. It's not hard to kill two guys with a big AoE explosion.
So now we're into, to make sure we're all following.
Uh-huh.
I use my missile to defeat an enemy.
Hold on. Start at the top. While I'm hovering.
Actually, do the gun next, because then we can go through the whole thing.
Okay.
Because the hovering part, you're right, it's the most critical.
It's the most critical
point,
part of this.
Which is where we go.
Okay. So this is, I've got two items here. We talked earlier about combos.
Yep.
So normally, a weapon doesn't apply any status effects. This one, that
does.
Number should be 10, but if I hit somebody 10 times, it will light them on fire.
Right.
Which will then prime them for a combo.
Then you can use the detonators and the combos.
Right.
Okay.
So while I'm hovering, I get Raptor Sense, which gives me extra weak point damage. So while not vital to my build, is an extra perk while I'm hovering, because I'm already
it's
hovering.
It's incentivizing hovering. So if you didn't manage to defeat an enemy, you could clean them up pretty easily with the bonus weak point damage. Okay, so then what we're going to do is, we weren't planning to show this, but I think we can show it. I don't know, we're low on time, but if our lovely stream team will allow us to show it, why don't we try to show it? All right, thumbs up. We'll swap back just to our heads, answer some questions, and then we'll get ourselves loaded up. But let's just describe the sum of all of that real quick.
Yes, let's sum it up.
So, you correct me
this
when I'm
item.
Wrong.
Okay.
I hover. I'm getting reduced gear cooldowns
by half. Yes.
And weak point damage. I defeat an enemy with my missile.
Right.
It does bonus explosion damage, and it makes my grenades do 50% more damage for 3 seconds. If I use my grenade and get a 2 person multi-kill,
right.
It'll regenerate my shields. If I get a three-person multi-kill, it will fill my ultimate meter faster.
You got those numbers reversed, but yes.
But yeah, okay. For the fast. So after I do all of that, oh, can you load up into the thing? That's okay. So after I do all of that, if my ultimate's filled up, I use my ultimate, that increases all of my gear by, I can't remember the number now, it was 50% or something.
Yep.
Which at that point, my gear cooldowns are so low, they're probably refreshed, and I'm doing it all over again.
It's ludicrous.
That's ridiculous.
Yeah. So anyway, that so it sounds ludicrous and unbalanced, but if you want to push into, we've talked about, and I think you've seen on streams, Grandmaster difficulties and things
right.
like that, though you're required to have that power to push that content where you're getting better loot.
So you'll need this stuff if you want to be playing the top-end content.
Right.
Okay. And so on that, at launch, there'll be three difficulties as you play through the crit path and also get towards max level.
Right.
We've shown them, I think, it's Lancer, Freelancer, Master.
Mm-hmm.
And then there'll be three more difficulties available at launch once you unlock them that are Grandmaster 1, 2, and 3.
Right.
And that's where I think this kind of stuff comes into play. But also by doing that harder content, you get a higher chance of getting these more rare mm-hmm. items like Masterworks and things like that.
Right.
Okay, so we're going to show all of that. But while we're just getting ourselves worked, sorted out, let's do a couple more questions. If we have some. Okay. That's a good question. It's very on topic. Let's say there is a legendary gun called the Exploder. is there going to be only one version of that gun with fixed stats, or can we find an infinite version of the same gun with better rolls on the stats so that we don't end up with the same builds?
Yeah. So, as we said, if the Exploder is a masterwork,
that explodes, let's say.
That if its orange property, the orange property that it has, mm-hmm. will always be the same on the Exploder.
Right.
But the infusions on it will be different.
Right.
So because there's a wide variety of builds, multiple builds could use the Exploder. And depending on what build I use the Exploder in, I may want different stats. So it's
right.
perfect for me if it's got thruster on it so they can hover more.
Right.
But if I'm not hover-based, if I'm melee-based,
then
I don't care about it. Right.
All right. So we're going to flip ourselves over to free play. I think we're sorted out here. All right. We are good to go.
Okay.
So
we've talked about grenade
right.
refresh.
Right.
So let me show
you. You want to explain that?
I want to see it.
Right.
So I think it's about 12 seconds. So you see the little bar raise. Now watch what happens when I hover.
Yeah, it's half.
Much faster. Like, it's half.
Ridiculous. And you can see, they're the buffs on the left. Is that right?
Yes. Yeah. So, yeah, let me do that
again. I can't
remember
which one was which, but...
So, Raptor's Relief is the cooldown reduction,
yep.
and Raptor Sense is my
weak
point.
Damage, yeah.
So, you can see, and you see the electric explosion there that happened?
Yeah.
Okay, so let's do...
So, you've got to defeat an enemy with your missile launcher.
So, I'm going to do that.
Oh, he didn't.
Didn't kill him. It's okay. I do a bunch of damage with that grenade, so it's cool. And it comes back fast.
Yeah, you better get on the ground. Okay. So, let's see if we can get this here.
Okay.
So you defeated him.
Oh, see the,
you got Victor's boost, I guess, which is grenade does extra damage, and then you got the grenade kill.
Right.
If that was a multi-kill, if it
I
was
have
three,
shield.
You get your shield back.
Yeah,
and if
right.
it was two, we'd see our ultimate meter
go up.
Dip up. And I think one of the bugs here is you have a bunch of plus thruster, and I think it's not working,
nor is the ultimate regeneration that I have.
Oh,
regeneration isn't working either.
Yeah, so you'd be able to hover longer and probably get your ultimate even faster than what we're seeing here.
Right. Oh, I missed.
That's fine, because if you miss, you got to get those weak point hits through. Okay, so while
right,
you're doing this, I'll field some extra questions as you keep explaining stuff.
All right, so yeah, the grenades are really powerful, but slow, and we balance them that way. But this is a good way around
that.
Right. I ran into some trees
there.
Here you
go. Now we're perfectly set up. Boom into.
Oh, it didn't
really?
Kill him. Yeah.
Okay.
So I chose hard difficulty.
Oh, did you?
Yeah. So that we didn't one shot everything. Sometimes these things, but you have to choose the right targets.
Right. No, but I think, you know, just even showing off how when you weren't hovering versus hovering, like, look how fast those cooldowns are coming up. Yeah. Like, it's crazy when you're in hover mode. And then Darren's actually doing something, maybe subtle here, but he's purposely playing around the water. So as he's overheating, he's coming back and cooling himself faster by playing through the water.
Right.
So there's a lot of, like, there's some environmental things you can do here to help.
All right, okay, there we go.
Oh, that might be it. Nice.
Okay. Oh,
so your ultimate shot me out of the air. So if you also now, you could get your ultimate shot.
Yeah.
Awesome. All right, I'll answer some questions. Do bosses drop unique loot? Like, if I did a stronghold and killed one of those giant gorilla-looking things,
a gorilla
could I get, I don't know, a crazy quad-barreled shotgun? Man, I like the creativity in the question.
I have to make that.
So I think we've kind of addressed this, but generally the answer is by playing the game, there are loot tables, and the harder the content you play gives you higher chances of rarity amongst the loot tables. And those loot tables are kind of, if you're playing a ranger, you're more likely to get more ranger gear or mostly ranger gear. Separately to that, we have a challenge system. So you can think of it as what some other games kind of use achievements as like, but there might be a challenge to be like, hey, go kill the giant gorilla thing 10 times, and on the 10th time you get a specific reward. And so we're trying to work out exactly how we'll kind of mix those challenges in to the rest of the game. But the primary thing will be there are loot tables, and then between crafting and challenges, there'll be some outs to chase certain things. Okay, is there anything else you want to show? Because we're actually over time. Is there anything else you want to show here?
I mean, not really. I think we've complicated this enough. there's more things I could add to this build. There was a whole bunch of other stuff that I thought I should put in here, but
we
wanted
this to
enough.
Be the kickoff, right? So players could go, oh, wow, okay. Just with those things they've told us, which is only a small subset of all of the options available, man, what are all the different kind of options and thoughts we have of cool things that we can do? So what we might do then is flip. Well, actually, you can just keep playing around for a bit. I'll answer a few more questions, and then we'll start to wrap it up. So supportability got asked as a question.
Oh yeah,
we didn't show it, which actually, for what you're doing here, would be super useful.
It would
probably.
Would have been super useful.
Yeah.
Let me see if I can. It's free play, folks. So I don't know where the people are.
There we go. There was an event. Oh, you missed it. That was too late. It's fine. There's some down there to the right. I shouldn't backseat drive. I think the lesson we learned right now is don't let Dan backseat drive.
I just need... So the equipment that I have here is the muster point, the rally point, rather. So,
don't you have bulwark on?
Do I? Okay, you're right. So this puts a shield around me so that the projectiles can't get in.
Yep.
It doesn't... it blocks them, which is super handy.
Oh, wyverns.
Against wyverns.
Do it.
I was overheating. Remember? but I can pop it in the air. If I time it incorrectly, I can't.
Yeah, so the bulwark, it is... Oh, nice, you found the ring gate. The bulwark will prevent projectiles coming in. So if you didn't get set on fire
all
from
the time,
the raptors and shot
exactly.
out of the sky...
It would have been much more dramatic.
But see, now you're hovering, though, to get it back faster so we can show it off, which is kind of cool.
So they have a long cooldown, but it's shortened when I'm hovering.
Okay, so we showed that. Is loot individual or shared? So loot is instanced to be individual loot. And again, there's no trading. It's really about you having to go and earn the loot yourself. And of course, any loot you get, you got two Ursics.
Yeah,
you
no, I'm not going to be able
probably
to.
I should
run away, I know.
and remember, you want to salvage loot you're not going to use to get crafting materials to craft things that you may really not have.
Yep.
Do inscriptions stack? I assume this means if I had 2+5% flight times, would they work together?
They do. Yep, for sure.
They sure do. A question was, will high-level gear have wildly impactful abilities? I think that was an older question before we started showing all this, so the answer is yes.
The answer
as
is yes.
As you can see.
Right.
Pretty impactful stuff. You can work in kind of your own rotations, if you will, or play styles based on putting this together. I think you should just like
I know. Go away. Tempting fate.
So that's an interesting point, because you had mentioned this to me. We were playing around with this yesterday. You're like, you know, this build is really about having to defeat a lot of enemies pretty quickly. That's where you get the most value. So then when you fight like an Ursix, like this isn't the best build to go and fight single target, high hit point,
I can't get those activations.
That's the trade-off, right? Yep. Now you could have made a different build that was balanced for that.
And my impact build would have been great. Focused.
Yeah, your impact build would have been perfect for it. It's all about single target damage or weapons. So there's going to be a lot of trade-offs here. And then if you think you're just one player, you know, ideally you have a squad of you and three of your best friends. And you're trying to work out the builds that support the whole group, all four of you together.
Right.
So you might make a mixture of some people are there to take out the trash, so to speak, the easier to kill creatures, and other people are there to deal with the kind of, you know, priority target things, either the apex creatures like the Ursix, or even like a Scar Heavy, you know, things that are harder to defeat.
So another interesting thing that we see here, because it's not working, unfortunately, is I really needed the hover time to work. me stacking that stuff.
Yeah. Like, just loosely for players, like, do you think it would be about twice? Like, how much more hover are we talking? Because it's not infinite.
It's not infinite.
Oh, that was an awesome combo.
Yeah.
There you go.
Yeah, so it's not infinite. And these guys have a lot of health. But it needs to be extended to a point where I can reliably do a combo and not have to worry about falling out of the sky.
Right. Okay, that's cool. That's all part of the in-development nature of us grabbing a recent build that has some bugs. No big deal. Do enemies scale with your gear score? Or probably a better question is, how do enemies scale? Because we've talked about friends of any level can play together. So how would it work?
So the key to making that work is that enemies scale to your pilot level.
Right.
There are things that scale slightly differently, but the creatures.
Yeah. So the biggest boost you can get. Oh man, he's just wants. The biggest boost you can get is increasing your rarity. Is that right?
Increasing rarity and item.
Increasing rarity. Item level would be the best way to get ahead.
Item level and rarity.
Yep. Okay. Cool. And then we've talked about this before, but you know, if Darren's level 20 and I'm level 10, we can play together because we'll do, without getting into it, relative damage to the creatures and they'll do relative damage to us, so we can play together. But when Darren has a build like this with all these synergies, he will be more powerful than I will, or he will be able to defeat things faster because he has all these extra synergies and he has a breadth of things available to him. But we can still play together and have a lot of fun. He would never take me to do the hardest end game stuff.
Yeah, I think he would come
on my Crit Path missions, or we'd play, you know, whatever piece of content together on some of the regular difficulties, and we'd be having a great time. Are there builds that can improve your melee?
Oh yeah, absolutely. So again, I was the
of all the choices.
Somebody suggested that I actually make a tanky ranger melee build, and I could have done that too.
Yeah,
right. Lots of melee components and things that apply to that. Oh.
So one question was, can you show the other gun? Which I think is not working. Is that
it
right?
It doesn't work. Yes. I was so excited to play with it.
You got then, like 42 minutes in before being caught with a weapon that doesn't work.
Yeah.
Yeah, so we found out that was bugged. We have top people fixing said
Our
bug, but
people.
it's not part of this build right now. Okay, so we might do, I don't know, two more questions, and then we will sign off. We'll get a summary posted of the stream, and if there are questions in Reddit and or other parts of social media, like we're kind of around in general, we'll poke in and see if we can answer some for you. If we wanted to get, just a couple more questions. So I've seen this a couple of times. Will there be swords or other things? So right now, the way it works is each javelin has its own melee ability. Mm-hmm. So the ranger has the shock mace. It just has the shock mace. There are no other things. We like the idea of maybe somewhere down in the future, like we could do some more stuff. But at launch, everyone kind of has their one thing. And that will scale with pilot level and things like that. So the next question, I'll field this one as well. What about raids and endgame content? So that's a much longer answer. So a lot of the kind of core loop to the game as you get through the crypt path and get towards the endgame content is around taking on more challenging and more challenging content at those higher difficulties to get more rewards. Then the question says, but hey, like, I would like aspirational content. Like, it's important to have aspirational content. Mm-hmm. And so we have some things coming that we're not quite ready to talk about. But as we get into the new year, we'll give some more detail on that. But certainly at launch, there's a lot of content and a lot of difficulty levels and a lot of ways to challenge yourself with you and your friends to try to get these rewards, find out what these amazing builds are, find the builds that are right for you, find the build that's right for you and your group, find the build that's right for you and your group across the four javelins, across multiple loadouts. You know, there's really a lot of stuff to chase there, and a lot of amazing content to play to do it. But we'll talk about some of that other stuff a bit later. When can we see the Interceptor point of view? So, for those paying attention, a certain person promised we would show the Interceptor perspective next stream. Yeah, but what happened is last stream we had a couple of technical problems and we didn't get to show it. And then we promised we would show loot. But showing loot on the Interceptor that you'd never seen wasn't really going to make sense. So we wanted to show the Ranger so you could compare it to what the Ranger we've shown before. So our hope is that next time we do a gameplay stream, that we will show the Interceptor's perspective. And so I realize I promised this thing. It accidental promise breaking, not non-intentional.
I would have shown it for him.
Thanks, Darren. But we will show it. We'll show it next stream. Next stream that we show gameplay. How many caveats do I need here?
I need a lawyer
present. But yes, we want to show off. Like, we love the Interceptor too. Like, we're really excited. I mean, it was the last javelin that we built as a team, and it's been shown the least, and it's amazing. So we want to show it off as well. All right, so that's all the time we have for questions. We're going to do a little bit of a wrap-up here. So, what are some of the things we covered? Let's not go through it, but just talk about it. So we talk about pilots and pilot levels, how that works. There's lots of loot in the game. It comes in multiple rarities. As you push through rarities, you get more inscriptions. Mm-hmm. The inscriptions are random from a big pool of over 100 or about 100 different things. You can combine all of these things together to make unique builds as you get towards the end game and you get some of the higher end rarities, like the build we've shown up today. Within the forge itself, you can equip the three gear pieces, the two weapons, and then up to six components. And all of that as you level unlocks. So at level one, you have like a weapon and two gear pieces. And then at level four, you get like the second weapon. And at level, I don't remember, 12 or six, you get the third gear piece or however it works. And so all that unlocks on your journey to max pilot level. So that's kind of what we've covered today. We looked at the Colossus and the Ranger. So that was that. We're really excited to show this stuff off. You know, it's been a long time working on this, and it's great to show it off. Obviously, thanks to all of our amazing fans for tuning in again. You know, this community's been so great, so positive, and we really love interacting with all of you. So thanks for coming to watch us. Thank you to our amazing production team who set this up today. I don't know if you guys saw any of the photos we posted, but we really did a double upgrade to our streaming setup this time around.
It's fancy.
And it's been amazing. It's fancy. We have microphones and all this cool stuff. It's not that fancy, I guess, but we do have lots of fancy stuff. And the team actually was here super late last night, so thank you all so much. Obviously, thank you to the amazing dev team who built all this stuff. We get to represent them, which is great for us, but there are lots of people doing all this work in the background. So we're thankful to share that on behalf of them. We'll be announcing our next stream here pretty shortly to let you give you all a heads up of what we'll stream next. If you want to find out that information, you can follow us on Twitter at Anthem Game. You can follow me at Ben Ervo, because I like to go rogue and announce things sometimes also. But with all of that said and done, did you want to wish a farewell 21?
Yeah, farewell to anyone in particular. Anyone who came to who came to nerd out with me about builds, which is probably my favorite thing in the world.
Like when Darren and I play games together, this is where he gets deep. Like he gets lost in builds. And it's like, man, can we just play the game? Well, I've got to do my thing.
Yeah, no, this is your interests very closely aligned to our interests when it comes to having really cool things to allow you to customize your play.
Yep.
And be different than each other. Everyone wants to be individual.
Right. So and they'll to be see who can find that unique build that, right. that kind of blows everyone's mind. And we think there'll be a lot of community back and forth around trying to work.
Right.
That out.
Yep. And that's one of my favorite parts of being a developer.
Awesome. Well, Darren, thank you so much for coming on. It was awesome having your expertise to kind of talk through this with everyone. So thanks for joining us. Thanks, everyone, for tuning in. It's been a really fun stream, and we will see you all next time. Bye-bye.
Bye, folks.